Good morning. We are joined today from Feedback. It's of course Tom Oakley here to discuss your interim results for the 6 months to the 30th of November 2020. So significant momentum in creating a scalable platform for Bleepa. That's essentially the highlight of your report here, but we will dig further into the details here. First of all, a very good morning, a very warm welcome to Proactive, Tom. So maybe let's start here. What are your plans now for the further rollout of Bleepa across the Pennine Trust, Tom?
Morning. Yes, so really what we now need to do is to build on the momentum that we have generated over the last year with Bleepa. We are now almost a year into our deployment of Bleepa with Pennine Acute Hospitals Trust, where we have really sort of bottomed out and refined the product. We've taken a lot of frontline clinical learning, and we've really now got a very solid offering to take out into other healthcare sectors, both here within the UK, but also overseas. So I think really it's now to take the lessons that we've learned from this last year and really apply them to a wider market.
Yeah, we're going to talk about that overseas segment just a little bit later on. But the uptake from clinicians has been very positive. Why is that, Tom?
Well, I think Bleepa is a technology that clinicians have been asking for quite some time. I mean, it's one of the reasons that I left clinical practice myself, really, was to help us to get better technology, to actually work with technology that worked for us, rather than having to constantly fight against it in your sort of daily work. And we've seen the impact that Bleepa has had for frontline clinicians. I mean, from our benefits analysis from Pennine, we've saved 36.3 weeks of clinical time in the course of a year. That's almost the same as having another member of staff on your team. So I think we have really demonstrated that sort of digital technology like Bleepa, this is transformative for frontline clinicians. And I think that's why we can go forward with quite some confidence, knowing that Bleepa is going to be a very successful product, particularly in this post-COVID phase, where actually a number of clinicians are really looking at this space and thinking, well, should we continue working the way we are, or can we change? Is there a different way of doing things? How can we embrace digital, and how can we work more flexibly, more remotely? And I think digital has really come into its own during COVID as a way of doing that.
Mm-hmm. And in terms of further rollout plans here in the UK for Bleepa, what's on the agenda here?
Well, there's quite a lot we're actually doing in the domestic market. I'm a bit limited actually in what I can say, and we had hoped that some of it would have come off before the interim so we could have spoken to shareholders about it. But there's a number of things that we're actually doing actively in the background at the minute, and a number of trusts that we're in discussions with. We're also looking at how we might even be able to expand across the patch in Manchester. So there's an awful lot, I think, even within the NHS that we can do. We've also mentioned previously that we've looked in the private sector, and there are conversations ongoing there. And we've also been looking at parallel market segments, things like veterinary. So there's an awful lot underway. We're just working hard to try and convert that.
You've mentioned COVID a couple of times. How has that impacted the rollout of Bleepa?
So COVID has been, on one hand, well, it's been a bit of a double-edged sword, really. On one hand, it has really shown and highlighted the need for technologies like Bleepa, I think quite unequivocally. I think both for frontline clinicians, but also for hospital management. On the flip side of that, however, hospitals have understandably been completely consumed in their response to COVID. And that response has now shifted to trying to roll out the vaccination programme. And therefore, actually, despite the fact that our technology can really help and can really also protect frontline clinicians, I think what we have seen fairly universally across the NHS is just a lack of bandwidth to be able to engage with new solutions. However, what we are beginning to see is that is changing. Now that COVID, thankfully, is beginning to subside, and now that the vaccine program has been rolled out so successfully, the NHS is beginning to have more bandwidth, and we are beginning to have more conversations now about Bleepa going forwards. It was very interesting, actually, because COVID led to the formation of this NHS communication framework that Bleepa was appointed to. But I think as further evidence of the fact that it has been difficult to engage with trusts, there hasn't actually been a drawdown from that framework yet, despite the fact that it was launched in the summer. However, now that framework is in place and there is a vehicle for reimbursement, I'm confident that as trusts begin to come out of this COVID crisis, they will be looking for the right digital tools for their future delivery, and we should be very well positioned to capitalise on that.
Let's mention the overseas market, because you alluded to it earlier on. Why have you chosen India as a market?
So I think one of the things that we decided as a team to do in the face of fairly slow momentum with COVID here in the UK was to actually look at what other opportunities were available to a technology like Bleepa, and whether we could start to initiate that sort of engagement in parallel to our NHS work to try to stimulate some growth in those markets. And it just so happened that India, we had a long-standing history with through our product Texrad, but also a long-standing relationship with the Department of International Trade. And in December, there was a trade mission, a virtual trade mission out to India, and we were selected to be part of that trade mission. And so really that was a great, it was a great sort of beachhead for us to go and explore that market, socialize Bleepa with various stakeholders within the Indian market, and to get their feedback. And then hopefully to be able to then follow up and engage with those sites going forwards. So obviously we did that in December. We've had a number of very interesting conversations subsequently, and we should hopefully have some more news to report on that. Based on our initial success in India, we've actually appointed two people on the ground within India. One of the things we've learned from Texrad is that actually if you don't have an on-the-ground presence, it's very, very difficult to achieve sales. Mm-hmm. So actually we have a radiologist now who has joined the Bleepa team within India, and also someone who is very experienced at selling medtech products into the healthcare sector. And we're hoping that by working with those two individuals and with support from the Department of International Trade, we should really see some significant interest for Bleepa within the Indian market.
It's an enormous market as well, isn't it? Goodness me. Huge population of billions of people. You hinted upon this a bit earlier. Let's get back to the revenues, because how do you plan for feedback to scale up revenues in the future?
So I think in terms of revenue, the key strategy was always to move away from our previous revenue models, which was all about installation and then software maintenance, to one of recurring revenues through software as service. And that has been one of the main driving forces behind Bleepa. And it's one of the things that we will be looking to do as we roll Bleepa out into both, hopefully India and also here in the UK. We will have seen in the interims that actually our revenue has declined slightly since previous years. This actually was what we were anticipating, because we knew that revenues for Texrad were going to start to decline. Mm-hmm. Partly actually because of the success of Texrad within the research market, we actually have already saturated most of those opportunities. So we actually took the step with Texrad a long while ago to focus on Bleepa and to try to drive Bleepa in as our sort of flagship product. And what we'll see going forwards is a move away from our traditional revenue models to one of software as service and recurring revenue.
So in terms of the priority when it comes to spending in this period, has it been developing Bleepa then, and will this continue?
So spend in this period has really been twofold. So one has been refining the product from the clinical feedback we've had from deployments such as Pennine, mm-hmm. to really refine the value proposition for customers, both within the NHS and private sector. But it's also been to start to explore and to open up market opportunities such as in India. We've also looked at how we can further highlight Bleepa to the market. Hopefully shareholders will have seen that we've been doing a lot of media and a lot of social media around Bleepa to really try to highlight the product, show its capabilities, and try to stimulate a movement among clinicians to really try and drive some widespread adoption.
So do you think this spending trajectory will continue?
I think so. I think what we will see is that as some of the customer sites begin to come out from COVID, we will need to adjust the spend to actually focus more on deployment of a product. As we begin to win contracts, it will become much more about user management, user engagement and training, and less about actually development and refining of the product. And so I think we will see the spend continue, but it will just be refocused.
Brilliant. Tom Oakley, thank you so much indeed this morning here on Proactive London from Feedback.
Thanks very much.